there was an immediate connection. He made a connection with his diocese, the Diocese of Rome. He referred to that. The pastor came to meet his people, and it was beautiful. Then he took the microphone again, and he didn't follow the book. Thank God. Once in a while, we need that.
Maybe that's a good thing right now.
Once in a while, we need that.
Can you tell me, what was your first reaction to the name when you heard that he had taken the name Pope Francis? What first went through your mind?
Everything. Francis of Assisi and this pope, they're kindred spirits. Francis of Assisi is the patron of Italy and the universal saint and someone who reached out between all kinds of lines and divisions. Someone who turned his back on the wealth of his family and the lifestyle he had and bonded with lepers and the poor. And here's this pope who's known for his care for AIDS patients and people who are very sick, who's known for his concern with single mothers whose babies were refused to be baptized by priests in his diocese. And he scolded those priests last year and said, how can you turn these people away when they belong to us? And here's a pope that's going to come in and look at a situation and say, get back to basics. This is about the gospel. This is about what we are at our best. We're called to be saints. And I just said, wow. He's going to build on the beautiful teaching of Benedict, on the outreach of John Paul II, on the smile of John Paul I, and on that magnanimous heart of John the 23rd.